When we were young, we saw people pretty much in the mode of what you see is what you get. It didn't occur to us that people might have hidden lives where their behavior was drastically different from their public persona. In our minds, nice guys were always nice, day or night, in private or in public. But of course, that was not always the case. Jesus took note of this phenomenon as it relates to our public versus our hidden behavior. He declared, "Beware of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. For there's nothing covered that will not be revealed, nor hidden that will not be known." Sometimes it happens in this life that the hidden things are revealed. In recent years, we've had an abundance of scandals involving powerful men, particularly celebrities, news anchors, and television and movie stars whose lives were rocked with public exposure of sexual misconduct and sexual harassment of young women. We looked up to these men, but it turned out they weren't at all who we thought they were. They had a hidden side, a secret life, an ugly aspect of their life that they'd managed to keep hidden for many years, and often decades. Sadly, in the church, it's not always so very different. As I grew up, my family brought me to a church which was pastored by a man who seemed to be the model of propriety and religious correctness. And then, one day, after all his tough sermons and his exhortations to the members to live entirely upright lives, a lady accused him of molesting her little girl, and then another family made a similar accusation, and then woman after woman charged him with pressuring them into sex. This scandal rocked the church and became a major news story in the St. Louis area. The man who'd been looked on as next to God was revealed for the wicked wretch that he was. But there is a positive side to this idea of the hidden things being revealed. Although many men and women are far worse privately than they appear publicly, some are far better. In fact, we're commanded to be this way. Jesus tells us when we give to the poor or when we fast or pray, we should by all means keep it hidden and not let our left hand know what our right hand is doing. We who follow Jesus Christ must have a hidden secret life, but not a hidden life of immorality and shame, but a hidden life of righteousness and a deep walk with God. It can get somewhat discouraging, however, when we know that we have a secret inner life with God and Christ, and yet we don't seem to be seeing any great outward benefits from it, especially when others, whom we're almost certain don't pray as much as we do, seem to be more prosperous and problem-free. Or perhaps we feel that we go on day after day, year after year, laboring for Christ and His church, and yet we're unnoticed by nearly everybody, while others who are a bit more outgoing and popular get all the attention and commendation. In such cases, Jesus tells us not to worry, and He assures us there's nothing hidden which will not be revealed, nor has anything been kept secret but that it should come to light. But exactly how does our secret life come to the light of day? In the cases of some of the greatest and most effective ministers, someone usually writes a biography about their lives, and someone else may produce a video documentary about them. But such men and women are the exception. For every Christian man or woman who has a biography written about his or her life, there are millions who are never written about. When they die, their good works and deep spirituality will essentially disappear from Earth's history. They will die unsung, unheralded, and unknown. Well, not quite. The secret things of the godly will ultimately be revealed in a unique event which Paul calls the judgment seat of Christ. It is here where all the hidden things will be spilled out for everyone to see. Despite all the devil's lies, God was paying attention to us after all. He truly lives up to the name that Hagar gave him so very long ago, the Lord who sees. In that day, we will be glad that we kept our secret life with Christ a secret. We'll rejoice that we refuse to boast of our walk with God, our giving to His work, or our compassionate care toward the hurting. God was our audience all along.